Welcome to an example on how to solve a system of three linear equations with three unknowns using a matrix equation. Before we solve this system, let's review the procedure for using a matrix equation. The first step is to make sure the linear equations are in standard form, meaning we have the x terms, the y terms, and the z terms on the left side of the equation, and the constants on the right. Once the equations are in the correct form, we're going to form three matrices. Matrix A will be the coefficient matrix, matrix X will be the variable matrix, and matrix B will be the constant matrix. The elements in matrix A will be the coefficients of the X, Y, and Z terms. The variable matrix X will contain the variables used in the system, and matrix B will be the constants, or the values on the right side of each equation. Once we have these three matrices, the matrix equation will be matrix A times matrix X equals matrix B. Once we have it in this form, our goal is to solve the equation for matrix X. To do this, we'll find the inverse of matrix A and then multiply both sides of the equation by A inverse, here and here. And since matrix multiplication is not commutative, this order is important. We have to have A inverse times A on the left and A inverse times B on the right. Then we should recognize that A inverse times A is equal to the identity matrix, and the identity matrix times matrix X would just be matrix X. So looking at the right side of the equation, A inverse times B will be the solution to our system. So going back to our example, notice again all the equations are in standard form. So this will be matrix A, this will be matrix X, and this will be matrix B. So looking at the coefficients, the first row in matrix A will be 1, 2, negative 1. The second row will be 2, negative 3, negative 4. And the third row will be 1, 1, 1. Next, matrix X, because we're using the variables X, Y, and Z, will just be X, Y, Z. And matrix B will contain 7, negative 3, 0. Again, our goal here is to solve for matrix X. So our next step is to find the inverse of matrix A and then multiply both sides of the equation by A inverse. So we would have A inverse here times matrix A times matrix X equals A inverse times matrix B. Let's go ahead and fill in matrix A, X, and B, and then we'll find the inverse matrix. Now for this video, we're not going to find the inverse of the 3x3 matrix by hand, but I will put links on the screen to videos that will show how to find the inverse of a 3x3 matrix. We're going to go ahead and find A inverse using a calculator. So the first step is to enter matrix A, and we'll also enter matrix B. So we'll press second matrix, right arrow twice for edit, press enter, enter the dimensions, 3, enter, 3, enter, then enter in all of the elements. It's important to double check this because if one element is incorrect, of course we'll end up getting the wrong answer. Now let's go and enter matrix B. So we'll press second matrix, right arrow to edit, arrow down to matrix B, enter. The dimensions are 3x1. Enter the elements. And now we'll find the inverse of matrix A, so we'll go back to the home screen, second mode for quit, and then second matrix, select matrix A. The inverse key is x to the negative 1, press enter. We want to convert these decimals to fractions, so we're going to press math, enter, enter. And notice how we can only see the first two columns, but if we arrow to the right, we can see that third column. So we'll go ahead and copy this down by column. First column is negative 1/16, 3/8, negative 5/16. Second column is 3/16, negative 1/8, and negative 1/16. And the third column will be 11/16, negative 1/8, and 7/16. And of course, we also have A inverse on the right side of the equation. And looking at the left side of the equation, we should recognize that A inverse times A is going to be equal to a 3x3 identity matrix. And then the identity matrix times matrix X would just be matrix X. So we just have X, Y, Z here. And then on the right side, we have A inverse times B. Let's first make sure this product is defined. Matrix A inverse is a 3x3 matrix. Matrix B is a 3x1 matrix. So because the number of columns in the first matrix equals the number of rows in the second matrix, this product is defined, and the product will be a 3x1 matrix. Now again, we're not going to perform this multiplication by hand, but again, I will put a link on the screen to a video that will show how to multiply matrices by hand. For this video, we're going to go ahead and find this product in the calculator. We've already entered matrix A and matrix B into the calculator, so we just need to find the product of A inverse and B. So we'll press second, matrix, enter, x to the negative 1 times second matrix, matrix B, so number 2, enter, and enter. Notice the 3x1 matrix has the elements negative 1, 3, negative 2. Which means our solution is x equals negative 1, y equals 3, z equals negative 2. So as an ordered triple, we have negative 1, comma, 3, comma, negative 2. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful. Thank you for watching.